Hello, Prophetess Elise, your intel girl in the spirit world. Well, finally I'm doing a video on these darker realms. Now, I'm going to be talking about darker realms for you to get all spooky-looky and think you're going to access them and stuff like that. We're talking in terms of, you know, in terms of how people operate and use the darker realms, how the enemy operates, and how people who operate in those realms may affect you in your life, in your home, your family, your ministry, especially if they're dealing with witchcraft, especially if they were in the works of the flesh, especially if they're dealing with magistry, sorcery, wizardry, necromancy. If they're dealing with this, this is going to be pertaining to you and how it operates and how spirits are released to you, how, you know, demons are released to you either through witchcraft or through what the enemy is trying to do against you. So this is pretty much going to help you know the enemy or know the opponent. And so I've been, you know, pretty much dealing with, you know, a lot of the warfare that, you know, as those that are called God, because of all these attacks, you know, and all these things that's coming against me. But you have to know how to fight back and how to stand your ground. So the dark realms I'm talking about is the demonic warlords, the dark realms, how they operate. And I'm going to come from a particular set of scriptures, Ephesians 6, and then Revelations. Because the enemy has his own hierarchy. He has his own, you know, organization, and he works methodically and strategically to just kill, steal, and destroy. And he studies us, you know, explicitly so he can, you know, invade, attack us in our weak areas, in our vulnerable areas, or, you know, might come on, you know, a different angle. Since that didn't work, he'll try another one. So I'm going to come from Ephesians 6 because you have to realize that the higher you go in God, the more rank that you get. So Ephesians 6 verse 12, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rules of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. So you're dealing with the hierarchy of the demonic realm. And dark realms is when the enemy, you know, once he got kicked out, he got booted out, and he created his own area in the realms. He was no longer with God's heavenly realms. He is now in the realms where he does all his diabolical scheming and planning and plotting to, you know, destroy mankind, you know, influence them, and, you know, negatively, you know, cause them to, you know, cause division, sorrow, pain, and tragedy in the earth, you know, using, you know, men as influential men and women, mankind himself. So here, right here, for against flesh and blood, against principalities. Now, demonic princes are principalities in high places. And of course, you know, we have the regional demonic warlords as well that, you know, oversee different things that are happening in those particular regions. Now, I'm going to talk about demonic warlords, and especially in the sense that they do come, you know, they come to attack pretty much every aspect of your life. If you're being attacked in every area of your life, just know that's probably a demonic warlord. It's a principality that has released a demonic warlord against you. And sometimes they send more than one, sometimes they send many, you know, to come against you. And sometimes even people that are praying against you and operating witchcraft and sorcery and magic can release these spirits as well to people. You know, as they, you know, they release spirits and release demons unto you to attack you. And you have to be aware and subsistent and, you know, discerning in the spirit that you're not coming against flesh and blood. They may be operating through a family member. They may be operating, you know, at church. They may be operating in your workplace. They may be operating, you know, in your home life, in your personal life. You have to be able to identify that it's not that person. It's not, you know, the situation is whatever demonic spirit is behind it. Yes, we have the will of man. Yes, we have people that just make their own decisions. A lot of the stuff that's done demonically and destructively is demonic spirits involved and demonic warlords. Now, demonic warlords are kind of like, you know, they're like in ranking in the Pentagon. You know, they got the generals, and then you got the, you know, the CEO, you got the president, you got the commandment of chief, which is the enemy himself, the devil. And then you have his generals, and then you have his, you know, secretaries of state. Well, the demonic warlords are like the secretary of state. You know, they govern the regions. They look and see, okay, do we need to go out here and destroy them? Do we need to go out there? They're kind of like the mercenaries in the demonic realm. They're kind of like the, you know, the Navy SEALs in the demonic realm. They come out, they seek them out. They're mercenaries. They're there to destroy, and they're very destructive and nature. They're more powerful than demonic spirits. They are more powerful than even principalities. Because principalities govern and rule and reign, but then they send forth the warlords, they send forth the spirits, they send forth the imps, they send forth everything else in order to govern. They have more power because they have more liberty and freedom to go to and fro and do what they need to do, seeking whom they may devour and destroy. So that is the demonic warlord here. Now, in this sense, against powers, against rulers of darkness, spiritual wickedness, rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Now, they have a demonic power. Their power is destroyed. And they pretty much strategically, personalize their attacks towards you. Now, if you're getting attacked in your mind, you're getting attacked in your body, soul, spirit, you're getting attacked in your finances, you're getting attacked in ministry, you're getting attacked at home, you're getting attacked by your family, you're getting attacked in your workplace, you're getting attacked at different angles of your life. They are strategically trying to destroy you in that different area. So you have to identify the attacks. You have to identify what the enemy is trying to do. Why are you feeling, why are you getting experiencing this? Where is it coming from? And then you have to go to God and seek God and get revelation and understanding and discernment to see how you can come against it, because you have the power over the enemy. He said he gave us power to tread over serpents and scorpions. We have power over the enemy, but we have to know that power. And then the things that we don't know, the enemy knows that and he comes against that. But once he know we have power and authority and we utilize it, then you can shut all this stuff down. They flee. When you resist the devil, he shall flee. You bind them up, they will be bound. You send them back to dry places, they go to dry places. So regardless of what they're coming with, how much power they're coming with, how much attacks and warfare that you're dealing with, how much you're going through and stuff like that, you have the power to come against him and send them back to the dry places. So that was another one, against the rulers of darkness of this world. This is where I talk about the witches and warlocks, you know, the sorcerer, the people that operate in the darker realms for the purpose of prestige, power, and control, territories, and manipulation. This is not necessarily always outside of, you know, just the secular world. Church do it a lot. A lot of people in the ministry, a lot of people in churches do utilize the witchcraft and warlock and sorcery. They will chant, they release spirits, they release demons, they'll cause you to have headaches, they'll cause you pain, they'll cause dissension, you know, disagreements, wedges between you and people. They will utilize whatever it is to get their control, because their mind is prestige, power, and control. It may be control over you, control over your finances, you know, for you to do their bidding, for them to run and, you know, run you over constantly. You know, they use whatever. They use tarot cards. They use, you know, potions. That's one thing. They have actually Christian people that actually have magic books. They study Aleister Crowley. They study Anton LaVey. They study the Wiccan witches. They study all of the Druid witches. They study, you know, the different New Age practices. And they actually practice them. Alchemy and you name it. They study these, you know, mortar and powder. They study how to create potions. They study cards that they can use against people. They study the Bible and use the Bible and mix it in with a potion. Use it with a talisman and an amulet to come against the people of God and destroy them. So this is within the ministry itself, within churches itself, because we think it's always outside. We know outside what they're doing. They will tell you flat out who they are, what they are. They're operating on believing God or Jesus. They're doing their own thing. But it's even more destructive when they're in the house of God. It's even more destructive when they have titles and positions. It's even more destructive when they're in leadership. And this is when we have a problem in leadership roles. When we have people that are operating in this type of, they're using the rules of darkness. They're operating the darker realms, and then they think they're going to operate in the spiritual realms, the godly realms. It doesn't work that way. Once you operate in the darker realms, Lord is done with you. He's like, unless you repent, you're going to get lost and caught up in it, and then they're going to suck you in, and then they're going to come to collect, either with your life, your soul, or the soul of your family, or your children. Whoever they're going to get, they're going to come to collect. But if you repent and you turn from that, then God can restore you back, and then the powers you did for evil, you can now do it for Jesus Christ, our Lord, and save people and deliver them, rather than trying to, you know, release potions or controlling attacks and sending spirits and demons and demonic warlords to people to attack people. So this is one of the things they do against spiritual wickedness in high places, spiritual wisdom, high places, high positions, high roles, you know, high authority. That could be in the church, that could be in the world, the high in government, it could be in the church or the world. Demonic warlords are released. When they're released to do one thing. They're almost like the hitmen. They're like the bounty hunters in the darker realms. They're there to steal, kill, and destroy. They're there to destroy, cause mayhem, cause destruction, cause dissension, you know. They cause things to happen in your life, and you wonder what's going on, why you being attacked like this, why you this coming against you like that. And then you have to identify what is being coming against you, and then you can use your mouth and release the angels to fight against you. Because as they have demonic warlords, they have angelic warlords. You have angelic gatekeepers. You have angelic archangels. You have angelic spirits that will help and minister to you and fight for you and bind them up and send them back to dry places with their swords, their shields, their powers, and whatever weapon of power they got, as well as angelic beings that will be there to protect you and govern you and keep the enemy off your back. And when he come and attack and afflict, then they bind them up and send the strong man back to his dry places, and then you get restored, renewed, and healed. And this is from personal experience. So when it comes to the darker realms, you have to study the opponent. You have to understand, you know, some of these things that you're experiencing is not of God. People always want to say, it's you, it's never a spirit. Yes, a spirit behind it when I'm constantly getting attacked by stuff. Now, we have free will. We have emotions. We have behavior. We have issues. But a lot of this stuff have an underlying spiritual component. Either the lack of God, the lack of God, you know, is more demonic than God. Or is a demonization in some form or fashion. Once you identify that, you're not going to operate in your flesh. You're not going to operate in your feelings. You're going to operate in the spirit. You're going to operate in God. You're going to pray and seek the Lord. You're going to fast and get strategy to overcome it. Because you're not going to overcome it in your flesh. I'm going to tell you that now. You're not going to deal with demonic principalities, people in dark realms, in your flesh. It's not going to work. You know, so this is what the Lord gave me for we wrestle now. The next video will be more about the end times ones, the ones that we are dealing with now, and why there's a rise of death and destruction in the earth, and that we have to get in a place in God in this season of time to understand that God, the enemy is not playing fair. He's not playing favorites. He's not playing, you know, in terms of letting you do whatever you want to do and you don't think he's going to come and collect and cut your life short. God is in this time where he wants his people to repent and turn to him. There's no long time. There's no time for wilderness. Your wilderness experience, you better get through it and stop going around the mulberry bush or you're going to stay in the bushes. Plain and simple. So keep praying with purpose and power. Make sure you share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I do have some live sessions that I did a long time ago on demonology that you might want to study. You know, the origins of the darker realms, but we're dealing with a lot of things in dark places, and people are operating in these darker realms, and you need to be aware of it, and you need to know when the darker realms are open up to you so you can shut them down in your life, in your spirit, your soul, and your family. God bless you. Love you.